Yo, what is going on YouTube? It is Dylan. We are back here with another Madden video. Now, today we're going to be going over one of my favorite zone beaters in all of Madden 21. And that's a new meta is going to be zone and like ultimate team and stuff. I thought this would be a good video to drop. If you could do me a favor though, make sure to leave a like on this video and also subscribe if you are new. We drop daily Madden content on the channel and we are on the road to 2K subscribers. And I greatly appreciate it. If you are new, hit that sub button. And on offense right here, we're going to go to a very popular formation, gun bunch. You can do this in a bunch of different playbooks. Right now I'm in New England. I know for sure Dolphins, Bills, and also like Jets and stuff pretty much have the same exact play. And the play I'm going to be talking about is going to be corner strike right here. Pretty much the same play as like mesh and like Jets bunch. And the one route in the field that is really important is that corner route to the outside bunch receiver. We're just going to go ahead. We're going to go against like a bunch of different zones, and first we're just going to be default zone drops, all that. Now for this you would want to be on like a hash too, so we're going to move the ball back. And the whole like point of this, right, is we're going to hit triangle square R1. We're going to smart route that, right? You see how it is like a nice little short corner route. And the reason why we have to come out in this play is this time right here, I'm going to go ahead, triangle square, and put them on a high route master corner route. And then we're going to do the same thing, triangle square R1. You see how it's just not the same. So we're going to reset the play right here. And then we're going to smart route Mike Evans again. Now, the way I like to set this up is triangle R1 streak, triangle X drag. And then with your running back, you can either block him or you can put him on like a little in route and have like two basically drags coming over the middle of the field. For right now, we're just going to block him. Now, why do I like to put my tight end on a drag instead of having him on that flat route to bring like underneath defenders down? In my opinion, like you really want to hit this fast, right? And for certain plays, that drag or like the little flat route underneath is going to mess up the space. Right here, we're actually going to save Tampa 2 for last. Right here, we're going to go up against cover 3 first. So right here, cover 3, same play design. We're going to go ahead and motion Mike Evans out. Boom, snap the ball. And then we can just pretty much throw that pass, lead it outside. Boom. Very easy, right? So after that, base cover 3, basically that'll work every time. First cover 4, palms. Now, people might press you and stuff. This right here is why I like the drag instead of the flat route. So right here, we're going to motion out once again. Boom, snap the ball. You'll see right here, boom, we can throw that. Now, I'm going to show you a difference with the flat route right here, okay? And we're going to keep the flat route on offense. So we're going to motion him out, snap the ball, and you'll see right here, that's, yeah, I mean, I agged him, but it really isn't a good throw. And I feel like match is going to be a lot more popular now. And then lastly right here, we got cover 2 sink with the soft squat instead of a cloud flat. We'll show this right here. You'll see this is why I kind of saved cover 2 for last, because that's the zone that's going to really guard it. It's going to be a zone on the outside CB, just a base zone, just a cloud flat, okay? I feel like a lot of people would do something like this. Like it'd be like this kind of look, right? Or it'd be like this. I didn't mean the baseline, but it'd be like this, like an outside third and then like a middle third, something like this, right? I feel like this is going to be the more popular thing. You're not really going to see a whole lot of like stop Tampa 2, right? And Tampa 2 is one of the easiest ones to like bomb deep. I feel like this is going to be the more popular thing you see. And this time we'll run this once again. Boom, motion him out. And since, you know, he wasn't exactly, he wasn't exactly on the receiver, we can throw that and the stock cloud just doesn't matter. Right here, first attempt 2, this is when the other side of the field comes into play and we're going to go ahead and wait, and then boom, you have your corner route right there. So that's a really good play for like Tampa 2-2. Again, you know, they're going to have that stock zone, that stock cloud flat. Now, let's go ahead. Let's mess around with zone drops a little bit and let's see how it plays. You already saw it pretty much beat Matt. And also, I didn't show up at that corner route, that little C route. That's going to beat match coverage as well. Here, we're going to go into coaching adjustments and we're going to do 25 flat and we're going to do 5 yard curl flat. So we're going to mix it up too. We'll put like 15 and 10 too. First things first, we're going to come back out in Tampa 2. Same exact play. We're going to motion them out. This time it has zone drops though, so guess what, boom, that now becomes throwable first Tampa 2 if they do have zone drops on. Again, to guard this you're gonna need a stock cloud, okay? You're gonna need a stock cloud. Here we're gonna do the popular thing where people like to double Mabel one side. So again, that's a 25 yard cloud and that's a 5 yard curl flat. We'll even press this time and we'll go ahead, we'll motion them out, boom, snap the ball, and guess what, we can throw it. You know, it's not just because it's regs either, I promise you. Hopping him up, it's going to work. That's why I didn't pick Aaron Rodgers either. Tom Brady only has set feet lead. He doesn't have pass lead. He doesn't have gunslinger. I know it's still a throw power ability, but you will be able to throw this in ultimate team too. This time what we're going to do is we're going to put Kevin King in an outside third. We're going to put a triangle in a cloud flat and then this corner right here in a curl flat. Just to show you again, guess what? You can throw this. So again, same exact play setup. We're going to motion him out. Block my running back this time. Boom, motion him out. And guess what? Boom. Can throw it. This time right here on defense, 20-yard flats, 10-yard curl flats. Again, this is going to be, you're still going to be able to throw this. We're going to run just base Tampa 2 this time because that was the thing that we were struggling against in the first setup. Here, same exact play setup and Tampa 2 on defense. This time it is a 20-yard cloud. We're going to motion them out again. Boom. Snap the ball. Guess what? Boom. Can throw it. Oh. And that's okay. I'm glad that happened. It was, we had a long run without it happening. But the one thing you have to worry about with this play is this right here. So we motion him out, right? This is going to be a completion. But look what EA, like, your receiver runs backwards for a second and he just doesn't go towards the ball. So that's the one thing that really sucks about this play is that you get this animation sometimes. And then since you're throwing it like right off the break, the corner can't go ahead and make a play. We'll throw it again though, just to show that you can throw this. Boom, boom, boom. Again, right here, we're gonna motion them out. Boom, snap the ball. Guess what? Boom, there we go. So again, we can throw that. This time, we're gonna double Mabel, this time with a 20 and a 10. And right here, boom, gonna 20, 10. Boom, boom, boom. On offense, same exact play. Boom, block your running back, motion them out. Snap the ball. And guess what? Boom, can throw it. So again, we'll try a 15, I guess, but we'll do the thing we did before. Put him in a third, boom, boom, something like this, something like that. So again, same exact play on offense, boom, boom, boom. This right here, and we're gonna motion him out. Go on, snap the ball, and guess what? Boom. This time right here, we're going to do 15-yard flats and then 20-yard curl flats just to show you that the curl flats, even if they're deeper, don't matter. Again, right here, we're going to run this stock Tampa 2 first play. So this one right here, first a 15-yard cloud flat is going to be the toughest one to throw. This time right here, though, we can throw it. And then, boom, right here, pass lead down. It's a little bit of a slightly more contested catch, but you still can get away with throwing it. And right here, what we're going to do is we're going to put a 25-yard curl flat, and then we're just going to back it up like a cover 3 look right here. Just putting him in 20 yards and then boom right here, boom. So same exact play, look at this, and guess what? We can still throw it, you know. So this time we'll go ahead, we'll double Mabel with a 20 yard curl and a 15 yard cloud, and then right here we're gonna do the same exact thing on offense, motion him out, boom, snap the ball, and boom, can throw it. So again, this is like one of my favorite zone beaters in the game. I feel like, like I said, the only way to defend this is basically a stock cloud, which if people are running zone, 9 times out of 10, they're going to be zone drops. And if they're running stock clouds, guess what you can do in gun bunts, right? All you got to do is out route, corner, streak, this right here. Boom. Guess what? That's going to cook the stock cloud. And we also have the deep corner, the C route on the other side of the field. That's going to be stock clouds too. So I really think this is one of the best zone beaters in the game. It's one of the toughest routes to guard, that motioned out corner route. The zones just don't get there, and this wasn't really usable for some man unless you got like a really good cut. So definitely seeing the zone meta, I think this play is going to be really popular. Yeah man, if you did enjoy, make sure to leave a like on this video and also subscribe if you are new. But other than that man, it has been your boy Dill, and I'm out. Peace y'all.